Okay, the if statement having, these are all the types of if statement we have discussed in the last class, previous class, previous three or four classes we have discussed. Okay, there is if without false statement, if with else, with elif and nested if. Okay, these are all the things we have discussed. And a simple if. Simple if condition and statements. The block, the colon is very, it's showing it's a compound statement. It's a block of, you know, that we have discussed. Okay. And the if condition should have the valid condition, proper condition. They evaluate how the condition will be get evaluated. If based on the given condition, it will check the condition is true or false. Okay. And it should be followed by the colon. That is the, then only it is considered as a compound statement, and it's telling its header. That is a compound statement header. Which one? The colon is denoting that one. Okay. So that is it's what it, that's what it is mandatory. And the statement inside must have the same indentation level. Okay, we should give the four spaces. That also we have used that. Okay, we have seen a number of examples. Okay, this is the example, the input monthly sale of employee and give bonus of 10%. That's what the sale is more than 50,000 means. Otherwise, bonus will be zero. Okay, so for that, are you seeing the program? It is asking the entire monthly sales. Okay, so if the monthly sale, that amount will be stored in the variable sale, isn't it? Correct, no?
Yes, sir.
So based on the thing, yeah. So based on the thing, again, the sale is greater than that. Whatever condition means, as you're seeing, if it is greater than 50,000 means, the bonus will be added. 10% will be added to that sale into 10 by 10. That is sorry, 10 by 100. Okay, so we are adding the bonus. So print statement, we are again printing it. Bonus equal to str of bonus. Okay, so we are just printing the value, converting into the string data type. Okay, so bonus in actually what is in data type means it is a number data type, especially integer. So what we given means zero we given, and inside the if condition, what is the data type of bonus means, that is float data type. Because what we are using, which operator we are using? Division operator using. We are using, no? So I already said, whenever we are using or wherever we are using division operator, okay? So the data type should be automatically converted into the float data type. Okay, this is implicit type conversion. Okay, this is called type conversion. Okay, type casting is explicitly. The next thing you can see, print of bonus, just we are making the print statement, plus this we are adding the concatenation, string of bonus. Bonus is a variable, no? So that contains the float value. Okay, that value we are converting into the string data type. STR is a constructor. Okay, that function, using the string function, we are converting the data type float into the characters. That is string. Okay, have you understood this one? Have you understood? Okay, fine. Yeah, Harnish, you are okay. You are out of town. Okay, fine, good. Okay, let you see the next one. If and else, that is using the, this is the syntax. If condition, condition is true means this statement will execute. Okay, or else if condition is false means else part will execute. That's what we are saying. Else part will be what? It's a false part. Okay, whenever the condition is false, the else part will be started to execute. Okay, that is the if else. Okay, this example also we have discussed. If we are recapping, we already spent more time for the if conditions. Hope that. Voting, you have done the program also, isn't it? Have you done it? No, given as a homework. We have to check whether any person is eligible to poll their vote or not. So the vote will be, eligibility will be calculated based on their age, no? So if the age is greater than or equal to 18 means they are eligible. If it is not means, less than 18 means not eligible. That's what the program. So these are all the things we have seen. And if with elif, if condition, yesterday program also, yesterday class also, we have discussed the thing. But I didn't get any homework from you. That's the very poor part from you, from your things. Why it is happening? What's happened to you? Why didn't submit the homework? Clearly asked me to submit the homework yesterday, but you people didn't submit the homework. Even though yes, Adityan. Aditya Pandian. You're about to say something.
No, sir.
Okay.
Nothing, sir.
Yeah, that's what. Why you people not completed the homework? I already said you have to come and submit on the open day, but you didn't done it. but I given one more extra time also. That is yesterday I given the warning. So even though you didn't submit, okay, let you just decide it. So it's totally it's wrong. Okay, so let you people want to face this. I have done lot of example programs for you in order to understand. Yesterday's class I made you to be very clear about the things, isn't it? You all people said that, sir, now I get all the clarity. So, but even though what the hesitation you are having to complete it, complete the homeworks. Okay, it's just a very easy homework I have given. But even though you didn't complete it, so let me see it. Okay, elif condition, you can see the syntax. This is very important. Syntax is very important. Elif, then condition, next condition. If the first condition is false, then only it goes to the elif, second condition. Okay, so if the second condition is true, means this statement, second statement will be executed. That block will be executed. Okay, suppose the second condition also false, it will go to the third condition. Okay, so for example, likewise, it will check all the elif statement. If all the elif statements are false, means that's what all the if conditions are false, means at last the else part will be executed. I already said, what is else part? It is a false part. All the condition are fails means, not true means, automatically the else part will be executed. Okay, that is the basic syntax for the elif. Okay. So temperature that we have seen, no? For example, enter input, enter the temperature of a water. For example, water boiling point is what? 100 degree, no? Am I right? Correct? You can see, if you can see this thing, we have to enter the temperature of a water. If it is greater than 100 degree, means definitely it will be started to, what's it? Converting into the vapor, no? The vapor will be started, no? So it will be transmission will happen from water, that is a liquid, to gaseous state. That's what gaseous state it is. Temperature is less than zero. 0 degree is what? It's a freezing point of the water, no? Correct. If it is less than zero, means definitely the water will be in what form? Three states of matter you have studied in your law classes, no? Solid, liquid, gas, isn't it? So if it is less than zero, means definitely it will be in ice, correct? No, that is in solid part. We can take it, no? That's what. Okay. If it is not greater than zero, not less than, not greater than 100, not less than zero, then definitely the water will be in the any boiling switch, boiling point or whatever thing, but it is in the water condition only, water medium only, or water state only, no? So this is an example for that program, okay? So many program we have seen. In nested if also we have done many program in the classes, okay? So what is the syntax? The syntax I'm saying repeatedly, it is very important. If you know the syntax, then only you can able to construct the program, or else it is not certainly. Okay, you can see if condition one, just note down condition one, why they are giving that, this is called outer condition. Okay, so then inner condition we are giving it. Okay, if condition is one is true, means then only the second condition will be executed. Have you got it? Suppose the first condition false, means what will happen here in this case? Elif, second, another condition, condition three will be checked. If the condition 3 also will be false, means else part will execute. Have you got it? Suppose condition 1 is true, means it will go inside the condition 2. It will check the condition 2. Okay. Suppose the condition 2 is fails, means what? Which will execute?
Else part.
This else part. Inside the condition 1, no? This else part will be executed. I am keeping the pointer, no? So that's its else part, yes, will be executed. Yeah. Suppose that is the case. Okay. You have to understand the structure of the nested if. So let you go to the next one. Storing conditions. That is, we can store the conditions into a variable. Then we can use it. Okay. Just it's a normal thing. Okay. Let me come to the next part. New part or new topic for this. We have spent a lot of time with the if condition, because that is very basic. And this is also very basic for all the programs. Okay. Looping conditions. Okay. What is loop? So before I will tell that, if you want to do repeatedly any works, that's called as loop. Okay. So have you seen one repeat symbol in your music player? Have you have the habit to hear songs? Do you have the habit to hear songs? Yes. Or at least, have you seen the video, no? YouTube videos at least. You may see the repeat or repeat symbol, no? Again, one arrow must be blended. That is called loop. Okay. That loop means what?
Yes.
Repeatedly the same action, the same song, or same video, or whatever thing, the same process will be happened. That is called looping. This concept is called looping. Okay. So here, if you want to make the statement, a particular statement, want to repeat again and again, then we have to use the loop. Correct? Yesterday I have said one example. So suppose you are going to hotel, for you, you order, for example, especially Pavitra ordered chapati. How many chapatis you added, ma? I mean, you order. Did she was here? I think today she was absent. I think she only ate 3 chapatis. Just for fun. Okay, let me see this. Suppose if you want to add more items, if you want to add more items, it is not possible in if condition, no? So again, you have to run the program only, okay? But if you want to execute a simple one on certain statement repeatedly, okay, then we have to use the looping statement, okay? Loop means, I hope you got it. Have you got what is the meaning of loop? To make a statement to repeatedly until the given condition to be fails. So we have to give one condition in the looping concept. So whenever condition is true, the loop will execute. Whenever the condition is false, the loop will start to execute. Have you got it? Have you understood the concept? Hello?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Too poor, I don't know. You are responding attendance also too and class attendance also. I don't know what I have done for you. Okay. So let you check it. There are 2 type of looping concept in Python. Actually, in C++ or Java, 3 type of loops are there. But in Python, 2 looping statements are there. One is for loop, another one is while loop. As you are seeing in the slide, first one is while loop and for loop. 2 type of looping concepts are there. Okay, let me see what is looping concept, how to use in the program, how to make use of it, or what is the use of the loop. Let me see it. Okay. So let me go to the next slide. Okay. Before that, I want to teach one function that is called range function. Okay. Range function. Okay. But it is a built-in function. Built-in function or inbuilt function in Python. Okay. So it is always built in with the Python interpreter. So what is the use of range function? We can give a number inside the function. You can see what is the syntax. You can check that. Range of. I'm keeping the pointer. Can you able to see range of lower limit, comma upper limit. Okay, actually 3 values are there. I will tell it. Okay, lower limit, upper limit, step value. Okay, let I will say one more thing. Range of lower value, comma upper value, comma step value. 3 things are the default statement. Okay, lower limit to upper limit, the loop will execute. Okay, if you see one example, you can very clearly understand it. Okay, so just to understand, just to listen this syntax alone. I will repeat again. Range of lower limit, comma upper limit. Again, one more statement also there, comma step value. Step, S-T-E, step value. Have you got it? That is the syntax of range function. Okay. So what is the use of the function, sir? Why you are teaching this? Suppose you are asking the question means the range function will decide how many times the loop want to execute. For example, it want to tell how many times the same set of execution want to be happened. The condition, no? That's what I said, no, based on the conditions. Okay, so the condition is one of the type of condition is range function. In the range function, we can set the limit, which is the lower limit, which is the upper limit. Okay, so with that, the loop will execute. Okay, let you see one example, you can easily understand it. Okay, for example, they given, you know, range 0, 7 will generate 0 to 6. What is the lower limit? Here in the second example, let you go for the first example. In red color, it is mentioned, no? Range of 1, 10. So what is the lower limit? 1. As per syntax part. Lower limit, comma, upper limit, comma, step value, I said. Lower limit means first 1. So 1 they given. What is the upper limit they given?
10.
So the loop will execute start from 1 to 9. It won't reach the 10 between. It's not from and to, between this time. Okay. So here, what is the thing? The lower limit are included, upper limit are excluded. Okay, which is upper limit? 10 will be excluded. So what is the next lower limit? 9. So 1 to 9 will be generated. That time, the loop will execute 9 times. Second example, you can see range of 0, 7. That means the loop will start from 0 and ends with what? It won't reach 7, but it will stop at 6. Very good answer. So the how many times the loop will execute?
6 times, sir.
Are you sure? You check it. We already
added 7 times.
Very good, very good. 7 times the loop will execute, including 0, I am saying. Okay. So 0 is the first time, and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Totally 7 times the loop will execute. Okay. That's what. Okay. let me see one example. Again, the range function, they are giving more examples. Okay, just listen it. Just see the slide. Okay, then we are using operators, in and not in operator. What operator this is? The types of operator we have seen, in and not in operator. Arithmetic operator, relation, logical, likewise, we have discussed lot of operators, no? In operator, not in operators. What's the name of the total operator? These operators are called as in what name? Membership operator. What operator this is? Hello?
Membership
operators. The membership operator, in and not in. Okay. In means it will check whether it is there or not. Not in means whether it is not here or not. That will check. Have you got my point? For example, I'm asking you, can you check the note in your in your table or in your cupboard? Likewise, we are asking. Suppose anybody is asking, what you will do? You will check whether the note is inside the cupboard or not. Let you check. No, that is in operator. Okay, you just make sure the note should not be inside the cupboard. That means what? Not in operator. You are making sure what? The note is supposed not to be inside the cupboard. That is not in operator. Okay, so in and not in operator. Dear children, I am saying just to keep this point in your mind. Whenever we are seeing one or two examples, automatically you can understand what is the use of it. Okay, I hope it will give a very basic idea. Whenever we come to the programming part, you can easily understand it. Okay, are you okay? Or else, what you want to say anything, Sasu? Let you say, please. Two obedient students I got, one is Rajesh, another one is Aditya Pandian. Both only following my words. Others are, let you decide how you people are. Okay, now Valavan also obeyed. Okay, good. Okay, let me see one example program. You can see, I will, this for example, I will show that in number. Okay, 5 in the list. It's a list, no? It's a square bracket. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Whether 5 is present in the list? In or not? This in, no?
In, sir.
That's what it will return true. Okay. So you can see 5 in 1, 2, 3, 4 in the list. 5 is there?
No, sir. No, sir.
Okay. That's the condition is false. Okay. Let you check another one. A in apple. Correct?
Yes, sir.
A is there. The letter A is there in the apple. Of course, it's there. Okay. National in international. Whether it is national, the word is present in international. The word?
Sir.
Yes, sir.
That's what is telling true. Okay. So let me go to the again. The for loop in Python. First, we'll discuss about the for loop. I already said two type of loops, for loop and while loop. Okay. That's the first point we have discussed. And second point, what we discussed means that what? Range function. That is lower limit, comma, upper limit, comma, step value. Step value, I didn't teach so far. I will teach with the example, live example. Okay. So in the loop, where and all we can use the for loop, sir. We can use in list, tuple, dictionary, string, in numbers, range function. Using the range function, using the membership operator, we can execute the range. You can see, for example, they are asking to print school. This is a syntax. I'll just give the example. School, principal, comma, PGT, comma, TGT, comma, PRT. Principal is what? One string. PGT is what? Another string, TGT, another string, PRT, another string. These are all the elements. Okay. For SM, SM means it's just a variable. We can give A, B, C, whatever thing. Have you got it? This is syntax.
Yes, sir.
For variable, any variable. Okay. In school, what is school? Don't say that school is the place to study, to learn in education, good in education, like general, not. What is school here?
Principal, PGT, TGT, PRT.
What is that? The entire thing is called as what? Whether it is a string or it's a list or tuple or dictionary.
List.
Very good. Very good. It is a list. School is a list. Correct? No? How you are saying it is a list? The group of elements is enclosed within what?
Square brackets.
Square brackets. Square brackets. If any elements is enclosed within square brackets, that is list. Parenthesis means tuple. P value pair with the curly brace means that is what? Dictionary. Correct, no? So only the double quotes alone, if it is there, without closed with this brackets or anything. Just for example, school equal to principal with double quotes. What is that? School is a string. Have you got it? So now let me come to the thing. For, it's a for loop. For loop syntax is for variable in the elements. What elements? School, it may be a list or tuple, dictionary, string, or range function, whatever we can use. Okay, print sm. So how the loop will execute? First, it will take the principal will be taken from the school that will be assigned to sm. Okay, sm is a variable. Okay, so it will print sm. So now first, what is in sm? Principal will be stored in the sm, no?
Principals.
Principal will be printed. Okay, next time pgt will be stored in sm. Sorry, pgt will be stored in sm. Next time, what is it asking? Print sm means what? Second line, what will print? Pgt will be printed. And third line, third time print
pgt.
Pgt. Fourth time, prt.
Prt.
Have you got it, no?
Yes, sir.
Understood. Yeah. For tuple, it's a tuple, no? Can you understand? Code equal to, within the parenthesis, we given an element, no? 10, 20, 30. So what is the output for this given program? For CD in code, what is CD? Can you say what is CD? Variable. It's a local
variable
which is used inside the for loop. We are using for loop. Okay. So first, what is code here?
Tuple.
Okay. So in the code, it's a tuple. The tuple contains how many elements?
Six
elements. So first, 10 will be assigned to the CD. Then it will print the CD. That means 10 will be get printed. In next line, 20 will be printed. Next time, 30 will be. Next time, 40. Then 50. Then 60. Likewise, it will print one by one. Okay. So these are all the things. So these are all example. Let me go for the real time example. Then you can understand very quickly. Okay. 1 minute. I will open the Python prompt. Listen very carefully, dear children. That's what I'm asking. Okay. For example, let me create a program. So shall I print all the even numbers? Shall we print all the even numbers? Okay.
Yes, sir.
For example, shall we print all the even numbers up to 10? Up to 10 shall we print? Or up to 11? Between 11,
yes, sir, up to 11.
The even numbers. Yeah. I will show how to use the range function. For example, I'm just giving for, okay, I is a variable. Okay. In range. Range function we have seen, no? Range function. What is the syntax?
Lower limit comma upper limit comma step value.
Okay, I will teach this one now. Okay, so what is the lower limit I given? So here we are about to print what? All the even numbers up to 10. Okay, just I am printing the print statement. Print, what is the thing? What is the program? Program to print all
even numbers.
Numbers up to 10. Okay, so let me just close this statement. Okay, now this is just a print statement. So let me come to the for loop. Okay, the for loop, just for understanding purpose, I'm given one space. Okay, it's not mandatory. For I in range of what is lower range? What is the lower range?
One.
So the even number, which is the lower range of even number? That's what I'm asking.
Two, sir.
Two is the very least range, no? Two. Okay. So, comma, upper range. We need up to 10, no? Correct.
Yes, sir.
So, 10 want to print means we should give what? 11.
11.
Correct? 11 we can give. Okay. Step value, I'm just giving. Default step value will be taken one. One by one it will take. Okay. But if I given two, now I will tell it. I will tell the thing. Okay. Step value given two. After that, I will explain. Okay. I'm just printing I, because I is, sorry, capital, 1 minute. Print I, okay. So now I am saving this program. You can, 1 minute. Giving the same file. I'm saving the same file. Okay, I'm just saving again. I'm running this file. Now you can see it's printing all the even numbers, no? 2, 4, 6, 8, 10.
Yes,
that will explain how it is executing.
Six, eight, 10.
first lower limit is what? 2. 2 will be assigned in the I value, correct? First 2 will be assigned to the I value, print I. Next statement, what we given? It's a condition statement, sorry. It is a compound statement, no? That's what I given the spaces before the print statement. It's a block of statement, okay? So print I, what is the value stored in I? 2, right? So it's printed, 2 it will be printed, okay? Step value 2, okay, what is the now I value? I value is what we executed. Oh, I'm asking the first I value is what? 2. Okay. So 2 value is 2 is assigned to the variable I. We printed the I. Okay. So 2 is printed. What is the step value we given here?
2, sir.
Next 2. So 2 plus 2, 4. Okay. So 4, whether it is 4 is in between the range, whether it is in the upper range. Less than upper range only, no? Correct?
Yes, sir.
So 4 is assigned to the variable I. Okay. So 4 will be printed. 4 plus 2, 6 will be get printed. And then 8 will be get printed. Then 10 will be get printed. Okay. 10 plus 2, what is the value? Step value is 2. That's what I'm adding.
12, sir.
12. Whether 12 is in range, upper limit is what? Maximum limit is?
No, sir.
11 only. So we should complete within 10 only, no? So, but this 12 is greater than 11, correct? No? Correct or not?
Yes, sir.
So, that's what it won't print. The loop will be stopped. Okay? This is the value. So, generally, I will... this is one of the example. So, suppose if you want to print, I will make it a comment line by giving this hashtag. Okay? So, I want to print the number from 1 to 10. So, 1 comma 11, if I give, means what will happen? First, 1 will be assigned. Here, I didn't give step value. What is the default step value? Means 1 will be the default step value. Have you got it? Hello?
Yes, sir.
Here, yeah.
Yes, sir.
What is the default lower limit? Lower limit also default we can give. Default means automatically it will take. Suppose you can see in this example, I will show one more case. Okay. Here, I didn't give any upper, I didn't give the lower limit, but I'm giving only the upper limit. Okay, then you may have the confusion, sir. 11 only given, no? Whether it will take as upper limit or lower limit. If you give two numbers, first number will be taken as a lower limit, second number will be taken as the upper limit, third number, if you give me, that will be taken as a step value. Okay, so what is the default automatic step value? Means 1. What is the default if we didn't give the lower limit? What is the default lower limit? Means 0. Okay. So now you can see what is the print statement. Can you understand? Can you say that what is the output of this function, this program?
0 to 10.
Very good. 0 to 10 will be printed. First 0 will be, I already said, no, what is the default lower limit? That is 0. Okay. So 0 will be assigned to I, print I. So 0 will be get printed. Next, what is the step value? We didn't give the step value, no. What is the default step value? 1. So 0 plus 1 is? 1. 1 is less than in the range or not? It is in the range. Correct. So then that 1 will be assigned to the variable I. Then we are printing I. So 1 will be printed. Okay. Likewise 2, 3, 4. Likewise reach 10. 10 plus 1, 11. Default value, step value is 1. So that's what it is 11. 11 is in range. It is equal to range. Less than range only it will print.
Yes, sir.
So it will equal to range. It won't print. It is not less than range. Condition is false. Okay, it's default condition, automatically it will take. Okay, that is the use of looping concept. So now it will be 10, up to 10 it will print. I will save this program, I will run that, you can understand it. You can see 0 to 10 it's printed, no? Have you understood?
Yes, sir.
So now you people understand how to print 0 to 10 number, how to print only the even number. Okay, now I will ask the question, how to print only the odd number? Let you say this one. Can you say this? I'm just making. So, yeah, please.
1 as a lower limit and 10 as a upper limit. Step where it should be.
1 minute, no, 1 minute. Up to 10, I'm saying. Okay, yeah, fine. 1 is lower limit. Comma. Yes. What is upper limit?
12 as the upper limit. 12
as the upper limit. Is it 11 is odd number, no? Suppose we want to print a program to print all upper odd numbers up to 10 only we ask. Correct? In this case, I'm asking. Up to 10 means 10 is the maximum. So less than 10, what are the odd numbers are there? 11 is greater than 10, no. Have you understand, ma? Hello?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So what will the value?
Yes, sir.
What I have to give?
10.
Okay. So let I give 10. So step value we need to give?
2.
Very good. Comma 2. So 1 plus 2, 1 will be printed. Next 1 plus 2, 3. Then 3 plus 2, 5. Then 7, 9. Correct? So 9 plus 2, 11. 11 is in the range. Upper range? No, it is greater than. So it will not exist. Correct? Very nicely you said. Okay, yeah. Let me see this output. You can see 1, 3, 5, 7, 9. Have you understood? Hello? Have you understood?
Yes, sir.
Very good. Very good. So this was the thing. Suppose I want to print the Python programming into 10 times. How to print? Instead of I, 10 times if you want to print means what I have to do? Just I'm giving 11 means. Sorry, 10 means. 0 to 9, how many times? 0 to 9, how many times?
10 times.
10 times. The print statement, instead of what I have to print, I want to print Python programming means. Okay? Python programming. Okay, just what we asked you to print, just we printed. Okay, so as you understand, I didn't give the lower limit. So default lower limit, 0 will be taken. I didn't give the step value. Default step value is what? 1 will be taken. Okay, so 0, 1, 2, 3, likewise, it goes to up to 9. Okay, have you got it? Now I am saving this program. I'm running it. 1 minute. Oh, I made a space. Okay, now you can see. Have you understand? I mean, the first line also is executed. Have you seen this? Python programming is printed. How many times did it count? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Have you got it? How to use the loop?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Somebody is asking to do the importation means you can use the computer. You can use the loop. That's what I explained. What is the use of the loop means? Loop means in order to execute a particular statement again and again. Then we have to go for the loop. Have you got it? Have you understand what is the concept of looping? Hello?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. 1 minute more, please rejoin it. Okay, rejoin. Let me discuss the remaining programs. Okay, rejoin quickly. Do you have any doubt means? Let you ask, please. Any doubt regarding looping concept means? You people having any doubt? Rajesh and Aditya? Remaining?
Sir.
Okay, okay. I hope you understand. Because the others are not muted, the unmuted, that's what I didn't ask. I hope you people are very genius. Okay, fine. Ooh, somebody is just relevant in your home. You are just playing the music, no?
No, sir. Outside, neighbors.
Seen that, we today by using the for loop, we done it. How to print the n number of numbers to print, how to print the text repeatedly, how to print the odd numbers, how to print the even numbers. That we have seen, correct? Am I right?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So, shall we do the multiplication table? Have you no multiplication table? Shall we print?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Shall we do it? By using the loop. Okay. So program multiplication to program to print multiplication table. Okay. So let me just type this one. Okay. First, we need to get the input. Which number table we need to print? Suppose I want to print a 19th table, sir. Shall we? So we need to get some input, no? Hello. Are you here?
Yes, sir.
Just kindly unmute it and just say that. Okay. So we need to get the input, no? Can you say the input statement? Excuse me. Can you say the input statement? Hello? I'm asking.
Any variable.
Any variable. So can you say that? Yeah, that's what I need, the entire statement.
A equal to.
Okay. Okay. A equal to. We are supposed to get the n, which table we want to print, no? We want to
int
print.
Of.
Very good. Int of. Value one only.
Input answer. Of.
Input of. Enter the.
Enter the table.
table number. Okay. Shall we like this? Yes, like that?
Yes, sir.
Okay, fine, fine. So let you just keep this thing. Okay, fine. You can see. So we got the enter the table number. Okay. So next, shall we print? If you want to print up to downward side, how up to 20 or up to 10? Let you decide. Up to what?
Up to 20.
20. So what is the lower limit you can set? Default lower limit is what? What is the default lower?
One.
Default lower limit, I mean.
No, sir. Default 0, sir.
Default 0. Whether table will start from 0? Not.
No, sir.
So let me give what? We have to give one. So we have to know one is the lower limit. Okay. And then upper limit up to 20, you asked to know. So then means?
Yes, what sir. Is the upper limit?
21. Very nice. So step value 1, 1 is 1, 2 is likewise. We need to say 1, 1, you know. So defaultly, what will be taken? What is the default statement? Step value.
1, sir.
1. So that will be taken automatically. We no need to give. Or else we can give means comma 1 we have to type. Okay. So it is not required. Just we will omit it. Okay. So default value will be taken. Okay. So now we need to print. Okay. 1 into 1. Okay. 1, 1 is we have to print. No. For example, what is the I only here variable we use? No. So first
yes,
1 I. Correct. So I comma into means we need to put the print statement. So inside the double quote, I just give the X symbol, that is into class symbol. Okay. 1 into what number we need to print?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. 1 into the required number. For example, 19 table, 119. Okay. 1 into 19 I have to print. Where the 19 is stored? I mean the table number is stored in variable. Yeah. Yeah. So yeah, comma 1 into 19. Then 119 equal to, we need to print, no? So let me use the double
yes,
quote and I close the single quote. 1 into 19 equal to, what is the output? 119?
I into A.
Very nice.
19.
I into means the star symbol. Have you got it? So I into.
Yes, sir.
The loop will be executed till 20 times. That's all. This is the multiplication table. Okay, that I will show that. I'm saving this file. Okay. So have you seen the code? Remaining people, Velavan is okay, Aditya is okay, remaining people, Akshaya, Stisha, what I am naming randomly, I am seeing him telling ma. Reshma, Sri and all, not at all coming nowadays, I think, so what I have to do is, many people are not coming, we can see all members on today, including me, that is 11 members, attendance is two worst. As people, ma'am, given the posted the message yesterday in WhatsApp, you people are attending means you people having that much dareness, no? I don't know how far you are taken. Whether it's showing, it's not showing the place to show your dareness. You are losing the content. Not only I'm talking for my subject, all the subjects I'm taking, I'm talking for them also. If you are not attending, you are losing the content. Later you can see you are going running behind the teacher. That will happen. You will, the teacher will ask you, okay, come tomorrow, like this, they will say, definitely you have to run it. So the absentee, I'm saying, if you are present, I will really appreciate it. That's good. Okay, so shall we run this program? Shall I run this?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, fine. Let's see, I'm running this. You can see this. Oh, the first statement. Program to print multiplication table, enter table number. So which table? 19, no? For example, whatever table, what table I have to type? Let you say. Hello. 30. Okay. 30 I entered. You can see this. 130 is 30. 230 are 60. Have you got it? 20, 30 are 600. Have you got it? Have you understood?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So that's all. Automatically it is printing. So that is the use of, that is a power power loop is a very much powerful tool in the programming language. So just a two line. Of course, I'm getting one input statement. I'm constructing a loop. That's all. Just to two line, we can print the multiplication table. Correct? Correct, no? Have you got
yes,
it?
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, I need to print the square root. Sorry, square values. Square table. I want to print the square table up to 30. So, let you say that. square table. Let you want to say this. Print square table. Square table means two square is, one square is what? What's one square?
One.
One only. Two square?
Four.
Four. Three square?
One, nine.
Nine.
One, nine.
Nine.
Nine. Four square?
16.
Likewise, is there, no? I want to print up to 30. 30, I'm asking. Okay? So, how to construct, how to create a program? Let you want to say. Enter the, instead of table number, what we need to give? Enter. Enter the lower limit. So, you give the, like that. Enter lower limit. Sorry, upper, yes, yeah, downward limit. Downward side limit. Okay? That's fine, no? It's understandable, no? So we are,
yes,
getting downward side. Okay, what is the loop we have to construct? So instead of 21, what is the downward side? Where we are getting the downward side? Hello?
A.
Okay, yes,
so
sir.
We have to give A, 1, comma A. 1 is the starting. A is, for example, I need up to 30 means 30 will be A. Okay? If I enter 10 means 10 will be the A value. Correct, no? So what is the print? I into, what is the A? Is it required? This format is not required. Let me move.
No, sir.
So now we need to print one square is. What is one? Where the one will be? First thing, I value, no?
I, sir.
Then in the single quote, singular double quote.
Square.
Okay, S-Q-U-R-E. Square is.
Yes.
One square is.
A into I.
What is it? A means 30, no? For example, I
into I.
What?
I into I, sir.
I into I. Very good. I into I. So what is I value? First I value is 1 will be assigned. 1 square is I into I. 1 into 1, 1. Second I value will be 2. Correct? Up to A, no? For example, A value is 10. Suppose 10 means. Okay? Second, 2 value will be assigned. This program is right? Are you thinking this program will be right?
Yes, sir.
I'm saying no. Let I will show that how it is, no. I need up to 10 things. Okay, let I will save it. I will show it is have some error. I'm entering up to 10 I need. Okay, but it is showing only 9. 10 is not showing, no. Have you got it? What is the error?
Yes, sir.
So what I have to give? Let you say that. Here, what mistake we have done?
Sir, upper limit.
What we need to give? Instead of A, we need to give
A plus 1.
A plus 1 means whatever. For example, I need A 10 means 10 plus 1 will be added. Have you got it? So I'm saying,
yes,
this. Now I'm running this program. So enter the downward side limit. It's asking. Again, I'm entering the 10. Now you can see this. 1 square is 1, 2 square is 4, 10 square is 100. Have you got it?
Yes, sir.
So can you say the cubic root? I mean cubic table. Cube tables. Cube table. Let you rewrite this program. Can you say that? Hello, remaining people, what you are doing? Only few people are answering. Aditya, Priyanka, and Velavan. Only few people are also there. What about the remaining? I don't know. Rajesh, not at all opening his mouth. Akshaya, what happened to you? Trisha, Mageshwari, Mridulla, what happened? What did you just say that? Hello? Tell the cube table.
One last statement. Instead of square, we have to write cube, sir.
So we are having exponential symbol, no? Double star symbol. Oh, that's okay.
Yes,
I understood. Yes, I will just make it. One cube is. So I'm just typing. Okay, that's fine. Okay. Yes, relevant. Next, what I have to type? Cube, no?
I into
I we can give. Or else another method. This is one method. Or else I exponential 3. That means I power of 3. Correct, no? I value is 1. 1 power 3 is what? 1.
Yes,
2 power 3 is what? 8. Correct?
8.
Likewise. Okay. So, I'm just saving this program. I'm running it. Now, you can see. It's asking up to... I'm just giving 10 again. You can see this. one cube is one, two cube is eight, correct? No, it's exactly
yes,
doing or not? Yeah, 10 cube is 1000. Fine, so 10 into 10, 100, 100 into 10, 1000. Correct? Got it? No,
yes, sir.
Yeah, so I hope you people got this program today. Homework is you have to write the same program in your homework notes, okay? That is printing the numbers, okay, up to 10 and add numbers up to 20. You want to write the program to generate. I will give the questions. I will type the question. I will send to you. Write a program to print add numbers up to number 20. Write a program to print all the even numbers up to 20. Okay. Then print the generate the number and square table, multiplication table, and cubic table. All those what we have discussed. Let you want to write in your note in proper. Then you have to send it. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Do you have any doubt? Any people having any doubt regarding this?
No, sir.
Okay, fine. I hope you people understood this one. If you have any doubt, just recap the video. You will get it. Or else you can make a phone call. Nothing to worry. Just I'm always saying that you people want to understand the concept. That's my aim. Okay. So just to make it happen.
Yes, sir.
Okay, friends, see you tomorrow. I will post the homework shortly. Okay. Maximum
yes,
4-5 I will show. That was the homework. What are the homeworks I have said? You can write the homework. You started to write in your homework note. That will be fine. Once you return, just check in your type this code in your mobile or PC. Then execute it. Then if you get the output, means okay. If you get any error, means rectify it. Okay, that was the thing. So just to verify that also. Okay. Thank you to all.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.